I could stay awake just to hear you breathing, watch you smile while you are sleeping, while you're far away and dreaming. I could spend my life in the sweet surrender. I could stay lost in this moment forever. Every moment spent with you is a moment I treasure. Don't wanna close my eyes, I don't wanna fall asleep, 'cause I miss you, baby, and I don't wanna miss a thing, 'cause even when I dream of you, the sweetest dream would never do, I'd still miss you, baby, and I don't wanna miss a thing. Lying close to you, feeling your me or see it, then I kiss your eyes and thank God we're together. I just wanna stay with you in this moment forever, forever and ever. I don't wanna close my eyes, I don't wanna fall asleep, 'cause
according to the American Cancer Society, breast cancer is the most common female cancer. Breast cancer is the uncontrollable growth of abnormal cells in the breast tissue. Today, breast cancer is normally diagnosed with the use of a mammogram. A mammogram is an X-ray of the breast. Other tests may also be done to evaluate the cancer. Tests such as physical exam, biopsy, imaging test, or even sometimes surgery. The TNM staging system classifies the cancer based on their T, N, and M stages. Letter T represents the tumor size and how and the spread to the skin or the chest wall under the breast. Letter N indicates whether the cancer had spread to the lymph nodes near the breast tissue and how many lymph nodes had been affected. The letter M indicates whether the cancer had spread to distant organs such as bones, liver, or pancreas.
Every year, it is estimated that there are around 12 million of new cases of cancer worldwide. The type of therapy that a doctor would recommend depends on the type of cancer and how far is the procedure and where on the body is located. But the majority of cancer treatments fall in one of three categories: radiation, chemotherapy, and surgery.
Chemotherapy kills or slows the growth of cancer cells within the patient's body using drugs. It is a more likely choice when cancer is located in several parts of the body. Radiation also kills or damages cancerous cells. Particular types of focused energy, called ionizing radiation, are directed at the site of the tumor. The DNA of the cancer cells is damaged, preventing them from replicating. This may slow the growth of the tumor, stop it, shrink the tumor, or kill cancer cells that remain after surgery. Various methods are used to direct the radiation at only the cancer cells, minimizing damage to nearby healthy tissue. In the case of surgery, the intent is to remove the tumor rather than to kill the cancerous cells that make it up. The potential benefits and risks of surgery will depend greatly on the type of tumor, its location, and a number of other factors. Because it involves cutting into the body, surgery almost always entails some side effects, although some newer, minimally invasive techniques, such as laparoscopic and robotic surgery, can help to reduce them.
There are two types of breast reconstruction. The first one, it's called immediate breast reconstruction, and it is done at the same time as the mastectomy. An advantage to this is that the chest tissue are not damaged by radiation therapy. This often means that the final result looks better. The second type of breast reconstruction is called the delayed breast reconstruction. This may be a better choice for some women who need radiation to the chest area after the mastectomy. The body image and self-esteem may improve after a reconstructive surgery, but it's not always the case. Breast reconstruction does not fix things people weren't happy about before the surgery. Tissue flap procedures. These procedures use tissue from your back, tummy, or tights to rebuild the breast. The two most common types of tissue flap procedures are the tram flap or transverse rectus abdominis muscle flap, which uses tissue from the lower tummy area, and the LD flap, which uses tissue from the upper back. This operation left two surgical sites, one where the tissue was taken and one when the reconstructive breast is. Breast reconstruction is a type of surgery for women who have had their entire breast removed. This procedure is called a mastectomy, and the surgery rebuilds the breast tissue so that it's about the same size and shape as it was before. It is important to note that the choice to have breast reconstruction is yours to make. Several types of operations can be done to reconstruct the breast. Patients can have a newly shaped breast with the use of a breast implant, their own tissue flap, or a combination of the two. A tissue flap is a section of their own skin, fat, and in some cases muscle, which are removed from their tummy, back, or other areas, the chest area.
We're not beautiful unless we're perfect. So I'm not perfect anymore. So society tells me I'm not beautiful anymore. I was 34. I found a lump.
Sorry, I have to tell you.
There were so many bright lights.
You have breast cancer.
The cancer hadn't been contained to the lump. I had to go back for a mastectomy. I just felt a bit like a number. They're getting younger and younger these days. How old's this one? They weren't caring about me. Then the anaesthetist looked at me and touched my hand and said, "How are you?" And that was almost my undoing. Considered having a breast reconstruction. I'm not physically or mentally prepared to put myself through any more pain. It was a totally surreal experience. Doctor's appointments, ultrasounds, mammograms, needle biopsies. The worst part was losing my hair. I called my girlfriend over and had her come and shave it all off for me. I took my hair, the cancer and the chemotherapy didn't. The most difficult part was the loneliness of it. It's like the analogy of a boxer. He has hundreds of people in the crowd cheering him on, but when it comes down to the fight, he's the only one that can step into the ring, and that's what breast cancer was like. My friends and family tried to be very positive about it, saying, well, in order to live, you'll need to lose your breast. It may have been just a breast, but it was my breast. I've come to terms with the loss of my breast, but I think I'll miss it until the day I die. I wear a prosthesis and I love my prosthesis. When I have it on, I look and more importantly feel like a real woman again.
Bueno, realmente a mí no me afectó mucho porque mi cáncer me lo detectan en una mamografía de rutina. Era bien chiquito. Y de ahí, bueno, no es bueno cuando te dicen que es cáncer, no te sientes feliz, pero no pensé que era el fin del mundo. Siempre pensé que había muchos recursos. Bueno, sí, uno se preocupa por si vuelve a salir, pero hay que tener fe en Dios y tengo que sí hacer un seguimiento, mamografía todos los años. Al principio eran cada 6 meses. Y ahora es cada 1 año. Y el doctor me puso un plan de tomar una pastillita diaria para acostarme que se llama Arimidex. Eso es para ayudarme.
Okay.
Ellos sufrieron más que yo. Se sentían más tristes. Mi hija sobre todo. Se ponía muy mal cuando iba a la consulta conmigo, porque ella pensaba que eso era lo más grave, pero no es lo más grave. Hay muchos recursos.
What identifies you as a woman?
Well, what identifies me as a woman would be not only my physical attributes, like my breasts and my curves, but also my long hair and my face, like I might do my eyebrows and my eyelashes and everything.
If you had breast cancer, would you have breast reconstructive surgery?
Yes, I would, because to me, breasts are very important to my life and they symbolize me as a woman, and I would feel not myself without them, so I would have a breast reconstruction surgery if I had cancer.
What identifies you as a woman?
Well, what identifies me as a woman, besides the physical characteristics, are the fact that I like to go shopping and paint my nails and hang out with my friends and eat chocolate.
If you had breast cancer, would you have breast reconstructive surgery?
Yeah, I think so, because as a woman, you wouldn't want to lose something that's such an essential part of being a woman, so I definitely would do it. And I know someone who had breast cancer and had a reconstructive surgery, and it was the best decision she made because it was a good reminder of surviving cancer.
But then I spent so many nights thinking how you did me wrong, and I grew strong, and I learned how.